We will talk about how the genetic code was discovered. Nuremberg and Mette conducted an experiment to determine if a specific RNA sequence codes for a specific amino acid. First, uracil nucleotides were treated with polypeptide phosphorylase to form a poly-U homopolymer. The poly-U mRNA was then added to a mixture of cell-free extract, one radioactively labeled amino acid, and 19 unlabeled amino acids. So, if the newly synthesized protein at the end of the experiment is radioactive, then the labeled amino acid must be in that protein, and the codon, in our case, poly-U, codes for that protein. The test tube was then incubated at 37 degrees Celsius. Translation took place and the protein precipitated at the bottom. The mixture with the protein is then filtered to allow the free amino acids to collect in the flask, while the filter was checked for radioactivity. One amino acid was radioactively labeled in each of the 20 trials. The newly synthesized protein that was radioactive from the filter that was tested contained the amino acid phenylalanine, which meant that the UUU codon codes for phenylalanine. It was also found that AAA codes for lysine and CCC codes for proline. But what are the sequences of the codons that are not homopolymers? To answer that question, Nuremberg and Leder conducted an experiment. First, synthetic mRNA with a trinucleotide, let's say GUU, 20 tRNAs attached to amino acids, with one of them being radioactively labeled, and ribosomes were mixed together. The ribosome bound the mRNA, in our case GUU, and the tRNA specified by that mRNA. The mixture was then passed through a nitrocellulose filter to allow the unbound tRNA to pass through the filter. tRNA paired with ribosome-bound mRNA sticks to the filter. The filter is then checked for radioactivity. The filtrate is radioactive if the trinucleotide codes for the radioactively labeled amino acid. In this case, mRNA with GUU binds with tRNA that is attached to valine. Therefore, the codon GUU specifies valine. This led to the identification of 61 codons and their respective amino acids. These experiments ultimately led to our knowledge of the genetic code, which has 64 codons, the remaining three being stop codons.